Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the pre-show of Knights of Glory 2. We're going to kick this off with a tag team championship matchup. We haven't had a tag team championship matchup in a while, to say the least. But nonetheless, we're going to start this off with the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles going against Operation Halo. These brothers know each other very much, so you know they're gonna work very well together. Here comes the champions, Operation Halo, Master Chief, and the Sarge. You can pretty much say they'll be champions pretty much for a while, to say the least. They haven't defended those titles in ages. So maybe ring rust will affect these two. Got a jam-packed night here for you guys. A crowd of more than 40,000 in attendance for this event taking place. Knights of Glory 2.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match scheduled under one fall is for the UWO Tag Team Championships. In the corner to my right, hailing from New York City, the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. And to the corner to my left, the UWO Tag Team Champions, Operation Halo.
I see Operation Halo handing the titles to the referee. Those titles are on the line here today. This should be a very good matchup between these two teams. Here we go, this match is underway. This championship matchup for the Tag Team Championships. And they lock up. Master Chief turns into a wrist lock. What is he planning to do? Now brings Raphael down to a knee. As you know, Master Chief is the more powerful of the two, but Raphael has a lot of agility. And a nice takedown there from Raphael, turning into a armbar. Raphael has Master Chief where he wants him, but Master Chief was able to break free. I think Raphael is showing a little bit too much arrogance to Master Chief. Raphael is known to have an attitude, and he just showed it right there. The handlock applied by Master Chief. But wait a second, Raphael pushes him off, catches him with a spinning sidewalk slam. Impressive maneuver there by Raphael. He goes for the cover and he hooks the leg. Can he get no? A quick kick out there by Master Chief. I gotta tell you, the card for Knights of Glory 2 is amazing. It's so much on the card. I'm pretty sure this is going to be the longest event in UWO history. It's a very important night. Wait a second, what's going on? Oh my goodness, a double foot stomp right onto the chest of Master Chief. But like I was saying, this is a very important night here at Knights of Glory. That's going to take place tomorrow. And the kick out there for Master Chief. It's going to be UWO versus the Super Smash Brothers. The ownership is on the line in the main event between Fry and Link. Nice back suplex there from Rio Nino. Rio Nino showing the strength. The Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles in their hometown trying to win the tag team championships. Nice dropkick there from Leonardo. Looks like a double team maneuver coming up. Kick right into the midsection of Master Chief. And Master Chief is down. Let's take a look at this replay, this double foot stomp, my goodness. Double foot stomp. A very effective tag team maneuver there by the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. But it did not get him a victory. As you saw, Master Chief kicked out at one. We're back to live action. With Raphael in control. Kicked in the midsection there by Raphael. Raphael with a nice kick right into the face, right into the head of Master Chief. And Master Chief is going to take a breather as he rolls outside the ring. Nice Meteora over the top rope. Like I said, the Ninja Turtles are very athletic. They know how to move in the middle of that ring. Elbow drop right to the back of Master Chief. Master Chief desperately has to make a tag. If he does it, we'll have new tag team champions. Nice and time roll over splash there by Raphael. But the Sarge was there to break it up. Wait a minute, what is Sarge doing? My goodness. Power driver there from the Sarge to Leonardo. Leonardo is on spaghetti legs. Wait a second, Master Chief powers up. Two clotheslines, dust beyonder, kick to the face. Did by Master Chief. He can make the tag to his partner, the Sarge, and he does. Was this the rocket boot? The rocket boot there from the Sarge. An effective tag team maneuver. This could be over. No. Only a two count, and this match continues. As you see, Leonardo is still out from that pile driver. My goodness, what a toss that was. What are they thinking of doing? Raphael's in trouble. They went high and low to take down Raphael. And Leonardo's back in his corner. I think Raphael has to make the tag now. Another tag team maneuver coming up. It's just an Irish whip. Oh, goodness. The velocity and power of that Irish whip just sent Raphael upside down into the corner. And Leonardo is begging his brother to make the tag. And a deadlift suplex there by the Sarge. We saw that earlier from Leonardo. I guess they're trying to show up the Ninja Turtles. Few kicks in the midsection and a kick right in the face there by the Sarge. Sarge now lifts up Raphael, drills him to the corner. Boy, this is not good. The Sarge with a moonsault, impressive. Can't believe he pulled that off. And no, another two count. And the Sarge cannot believe it. He thought that was the end of the matchup. But not just yet. Here we go again with this deadlift back suplex. And the tag here from the Sarge, and Master Chief is now the legal man. What's up, Raphael? What is he planning of doing? Well, not again. Now, Master Chief with the power driver. The assisted power driver from him using the bottom rope. Goes for the cover. This may be over. No. Raphael still has life left in him. And once again, Raphael back into the enemy corner. But not this maneuver again. Oh my goodness. Raphael, he has to make a tag. Or this match is going to be over. I'm not sure if the Ninja Turtles want to lose in their hometown here tonight. Or today, I should say. I mean, the lights out. It's still daytime. And the Sarge, with a flurry of strikes, throws Raphael into the turnbuckle. But wait a minute. A counter there from Raphael. Oh, but no, it was short. Lived, but a finest carry there from Raphael. Raphael is feeling it. He can't let his arrogance get the best of him. But Raphael's coming back. Spins him over and a kick to the face. And the Sarge is in the corner. Throws him to the opposite corner. Takes him down. Dropkick right into the face. This is Raphael's opportunity to make that tag. And it looks like he's going to do this. He does. There's a springboard dropkick to the back of the head to Master Chief. Now Leonardo going high risk. What is he thinking of doing? Nice black arrow there from Leonardo. But no, only a two count. Wait a second. Deadlift back suplex there from Leonardo. So knee to the face and a neck breaker. Very impressive combination there by Leonardo. Now what is Leonardo taking in a counter there from Master Chief, but a counter back there from Leonardo. Hit to the face. And a German suplex to follow up. Oh, counter there from the Sarge. I think Leonardo is calling for the end. And it catches the Sarge with a calf kick. Sarge back into their corner. Nice maneuver there from the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. This might be over. If Raphael goes for the cover, but not just yet. What is he thinking of doing? I would have went for the cover. Oh, see, that cost him. The Ninja Turtles are a little bit overzealous. They're a little bit too cocky here tonight. It's going to cost them. Big splash into the corner. Boy, this is not good. My goodness. He just squashed this turtle. That's not sanitary. I know we see a lot of squashed, you know, things on the street of New York City. I mean, I know it's pretty gruesome to say which. But in fact, never mind. Back to this matchup. The boot right into the face. They're from Master Chief. And once again, we're back to square one, but with Operation Halo being in control. Now, what's up? Raphael goes for the big boot once again, but no. A super kick back into the back of the head. Throws Master Chief into the turnbuckle to their corner. My goodness, kick right into the face and a kick to the bottom of Master Chief's legs, knocks down the Sarge. Leonetta goes for the cover. He hooks the leg. Wait a second. We got new tag team champions. The Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles have done it. My goodness, I can't believe it. Let's take a look at the replays of this matchup. We saw that spinning sidewalk slam there from Raphael. Then the double foot stomp. I thought that was over right there if Leonardo would have went for the cover. But he actually did, my mistake. But it was only a one count. And this, we had a squash turtle here. My goodness, this, and you saw the velocity of that Irish whip. And this was almost the finish of the matchup. The Leonardo hit the black arrow off the top rope. But it was not over just yet. Let's take a look at this replay again. That maneuver. I cannot believe Raphael kicked out. But actually, Leonardo broke that up. Let's take a look at that super kick to the back of the head again. Then the finishing maneuver, which ended the matchup. And from that, we have new tag team champions. And the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles in their hometown of New York City. There you have it, the champions. And will they make it? And will they last as champions here in UWO, since this tag team division looks like it's picking up back again? Here on the pre-show, we continue with this next matchup. It's going to be King Leonidas going against Deadpool. I'm not sure about King Leonidas' attitude as of late. He's been acting pretty arrogant. In his matches, he's been breaking up pinfalls. it has been costing them victories. I'm not sure why he's doing this. His reason is to prove himself. Not a wise decision by this warrior right here. I mean, he has all the credentials to be a champion, but he's not utilizing them the right way. Here comes Deadpool. Deadpool, as of late, has been on a slump with his matches. But recently, he had a pinfall against King Leonidas, and that's why this match is taking place here tonight. Will his victories continue in the biggest stage in UWO, Knights of Glory? This may be the pre-show, but it's still, this show still has a lot of meaning behind it. Can Deadpool pull this off again? Here we go, this match is underway. The final match of this pre-show. Deadpool going against King Leonidas. They lock up to start out this matchup. And a wrist lock here applied by Deadpool. King Leonidas find an escape. He does. It's a wrist lock. But Deadpool again finds a counter. He slaps in the back of the head. You know, Deadpool's pretty brash. The Leonidas takes him down into an arm bar. Oh my goodness, just drops the knees right into the arm of Deadpool. He's gonna do it again. Deadpool has to find an escape. He does, he rolls over. And lock up once again. Both men are trying to show up one another. At the start of this matchup, an Irish whip to the ropes. It catches Deadpool with a power slam. Now Leonidas cranking on the head of Deadpool. I'm not sure he was trying to pull his mask off or not. He might have been. And again, this wrenching on the head of Deadpool. Don't get it twisted. Leonidas is a powerful man. If he wraps those arms around you, it might be game over. Nice maneuver there from Leonidas. Goes for the cover, and he hooks the leg. No, only a two count. Deadpool was able to power out of that pinfall. Snapmare there from Leonidas. Lifts up Deadpool once again. My goodness, what a punch that face that was. That wasn't pretty. It wasn't elegant. It was just straight in your face. And oh, Deadpool again was able to kick out of that. Kick out of that pinfall. Lifts up Deadpool again. Drills him to the turnbuckle. What's he planning on doing? Leonidas, the tornado DDT. This might be over. Got two counts. Oh my goodness. And Leonidas cannot believe it. But at least Leonidas didn't break up the count like he always does. And the punch to the back of the head the familiar Nettison drops him down with the elbow to the chest. And the Knights may be confident this is Sparta kick. But no, Deadpool counters with an arm drag. Deadpool going high risk. I'm not sure this is wise. He catches him with a kick. Goes for the cover and he hooks the leg. No. A real two count. This is a float over DDT. They're from Deadpool. Deadpool again going high risk. Deadpool with the moonsault. Goes for the cover again. No. Only a two count. And Deadpool is feeling it. He has to stay on top of Leonidas if he wants a victory. And the DDT again. Another DDT there from Deadpool. It looks like he's calling for the end. And again with another DDT. This match might be over. And he's not yet done. Nice cutter there from Deadpool. No. Only a two count. Deadpool thought he had the match won. Deadpool might be getting a little frustrated. But when Deadpool gets frustrated, he usually loses his matches. See, that frustration cost him. As Leonidas is coming back. Leonidas, oh my goodness, what a power bomb that was. And no, what's this? A Boston Crab here applied by Leonidas after that power bomb. Will Deadpool escape this? Or is he gonna tap out? Leonidas just putting the pain on Deadpool's back with that Boston Crab. But wait a second. Deadpool was able to break free. And this match continues. I'm not sure if Leonidas knows what to do at the moment. And the European uppercut there from Leonidas catches Deadpool for calf kick. Leonidas thinking of doing. Leonidas showing off. You see, this is what I'm talking about this guy's attitude. Why is he being so arrogant? I know he has all the credentials, but don't be arrogant about it. The two counts, see? That arrogance cost him. He might have gotten the victory, but he wasted too much time. Leonidas takes down Deadpool once again. What's this guy on the fireman's carry? Oh, goodness. Nice fireman's carry slam there from Leonidas. Oh boy. This match might be over. This is Sparta kick. No. Deadpool sidesteps him. Snapmare takes down Leonidas. And another snapmare there from Deadpool. Wait a second. Here we go. The inside cradle. That's how he beat Leonidas the last time. And no. Leonidas kicks out. My goodness. A kick to the back of the head. There from Deadpool. Deadpool might be calling for the end. Oh, he's going for that roundhouse kick. Oh, there it is. That's a Sparta kick. This match is over. But no, Deadpool miraculously grabbed the bottom rope. My goodness, Deadpool got lucky on that one. Very nice ring awareness there from Deadpool. And now you see the frustration in Leonidas growing. This is not good for Deadpool's health. Like I said, Leonidas is a very powerful guy. Oh my god, just slams his head right into the steel post. Leonidas has lost it. And he's not abiding to the 10 count, I mean the 20 count here tonight. And again, this driving Deadpool's head right to the turnbuckle. Like I said, this is a 20 count, so he has a lot of time outside of that ring. But not again, oh my goodness. 3 times, he sent Deadpool's head right into that steel post. I know Deadpool has a high recovery rate, but that does not equal pain tolerance. Now what does Leonidas have on his mind with Deadpool? My goodness, a kick right to the side of the head. This match might be over if he hits this is Sparta kick. But no, Deadpool again sidesteps him. There it is, the roundhouse. He's not yet done. Leonidas does not know where he's at. It hits him again with the roundhouse. Deadpool goes for the cover. This match might be over. And it's over. Deadpool is victorious here tonight at Night of Glory. What a moment for this man right here. Catches Leonidas with 2 roundhouse kicks in a row to gain a win. Deadpool has the momentum. Can he keep up this winning streak against Leonidas? Pretty sure Deadpool is proud of himself, able to get his Night of Glory moment. Let's take a look at this replay. How this match ended. Leonidas going for the distant Sparta kick. He might have been too far away, given Deadpool too much time to recover. And he gets caught that roundhouse. And he was not yet done. And he hit him with a second roundhouse kick to the side of the head. And that was all she wrote. The ref went for the count, and that was all. Deadpool is the winner. Wait a second, what? Come on, Leonidas, what is this about? Like I said, this man has changed for the worse. Oh my goodness, this is Sparta kick. And to know Leonidas was one of the people who helped out UWO against the Super Smash Brothers earlier in Season 2 with Fry and James Bond. Now look at this. I'm not sure what's gotten into him. Oh, second distant Sparta kick. You've got to be kidding me. Oh, what time is going to do it for the third time? Come on, Leonidas, stop this. Ah. This is Sparta kick. And Deadpool is out for good. Can't believe the audacity. But anyway, ladies and gentlemen, let's run down the card for the main show of Night of Glory. It's going to be taking place tomorrow night. We're going to kick things off with a ladder match for the UWO Co-Championship. It's going to be Daniel LaRusso, the challenger, going against the champion himself, Luigi. There's going to be a false count anywhere matchup. It's going to be Kug going against Nocturna and Harley Quinn. You can tell this match is going to be off the handle. And coming up next, It's gonna be Mario going against Sonic the Hedgehog. And this personal rivalry between these two is pretty much Sega versus Nintendo. Then we have the Double Gauntlet matchup for the UWO Women's Championship. This is going to be very interesting, to say the least, and I'll explain the rules at the main show tomorrow. We're going to have Goku going against the Punisher, and it seems like the Punisher is having problems with Goku. I'm not sure why. He says he don't want his anime influence here in America. I mean, it sounds pretty wrong to say, but I guess that's the Punisher's beliefs. And he might have Zangief by his side. I'm gonna have James Bond going against Luke Skywalker. Luke Skywalker cost James Bond the UWO Championship at UWO Soul Survivor against Link at that Steel Cage match, and James Bond is looking for revenge against the Golden Shirt Champion, Luke Skywalker. I'm pretty sure Luke Skywalker is thinking of cashing in that title at Night of Glory. Then we'll have the Alumni Battle Royale. I got just the names that might be in it. I can't tell who it is. It's going to be a surprise. They pinned open challenge to anyone in CAW for the Royal Championship. I mean, it could be anybody in CAW. So let your mind explore that. Then this matchup, one of the most personal rivalries in UWO history, it's going to be Tommy Vercetti going against the Zack Ranger in a no-holds-barred matchup. I hope these guys just make it back, because I smell bad intentions from this matchup. Then this matchup, a non-sanctioned matchup between Wonder Woman going against Rita X. And there's a lot at stake. I've heard if Wonder Woman wins, Rita X is no more. I'm not sure what that means. I heard also rumors that Rita has a demon inside of her. That's what this match is all about. Can Wonder Woman defeat Rita X? In our main event, it's going to be Philip Day Fry, the Dark Horse, going against Link, the leader of the Super Smash Bros. And UWO and the Super Smash Bros. Ownership is on the line. And I'll see you guys tomorrow night.